Suleymanoglu. First warm up. Hello, Mutlu. First warm up. That was 40 kilos, and I was going to 60 kilos. Naeem's up to 70 kilos now. Look at that back position. Missed a second set. This is 80 kilos on the form. His third warm-up set. And what's the speed of this guy? Halil lifts tomorrow, by the way. Kilos, I'm not sure if I said that. Here's Naeem, 70 kilos. We keep hearing that he introduced that, and then we heard he had it. He's 3 days out from lifting. But I also heard that Naeem clean and jerk 197 and a half a few days ago. Hello, back up. This is 90 kilos for Halil. Second warm-up set for Halil. 70 kilos on the bar. Kilos. Remember, Mutlu is a 54 kilo lifter, so he's lifting tomorrow. First day of the competition. Quick. That was 70 kilos per set. That was 100 kilos. Okay, this is 140 kilos. We're moving this tomorrow. It's a 54 kilo lifter. Stretching out. This is 160 on the bar. Even though you see they slipped a 5 at 2.5 on call on one side and another 10 bump to the other. This is a probably what Mutlu is shooting for in the clean and jerk tomorrow. Actually, kind of interesting. Looks like he's going to front squat about what he hopes to clean and jerk tomorrow. It looks like he won't have any trouble at all standing up with it, does it? Naeem just came back. He'd had maybe about a 15-minute break or so. Looks like he's just warming up for clean and jerks. This guy doesn't get a break. Whether it's me videotaping him, TV, whatever, he's always being sought out. And he's always very gracious, too. He really hasn't let all this fame go to his head. I mean, he gets interviewed left, right, and every which way, and he's always very, very gracious about it. He's really a hero here. He's really considered a national treasure, I think. Second set, 70 kilos. To do a little squatting. That actually was 110 that last set. We couldn't decide was there 3 10s on each side, not just two. 130 kilos. I told you this guy can't get any relief. There goes his cellular phone. Same as last set. Off of 140. Plus 59 kilo lifter, and he competes the day after tomorrow, the defending world champion. Naim Suleymanoglu, it's Friday. He competes on Sunday, so this is 2 days out. It's just starting. Thank you. lowered the bar to 110. This is 145 kilos. Break of about maybe 15 minutes. He's not quite sure. 70 kilos. He actually went over another platform, picked up a bar that was loaded to 40. He did a couple of warm-ups with it. They're loading the bar to 90 kilos now. Okay, 90 kilos. 50. This is 180 kilos, 180, just under 400. Remember, my name's a 64 kilo lifter. Getting ready to squat. First set, 110 kilos. About handling 190 kilos. Oh, this is almost, that's almost triple body weight. Pretty amazing. This is Papa Laura from Cuba, 1991 world champion, 75 kilo class. A morning workout. I think they're just going really light. He just did some snatches with 100 kilos, very quick. This is 110. This is 120. Probably be lifting the day after tomorrow. Again, it's a morning workout, so I think it's just light loosening up. Thank you. like another set of 120 for Pablo. This is Roman Sevastiev, Ukraine. Started to warm up. He's had about maybe 10-minute massage from his trainer's shoulders. Did some hip circles, did some arm circles. Did some squats with no weight, just loosening up. He's got to be one of the favorites for medal in the 76-kilo class. So the second set is one warm-up with 50. Now we got 80 kilos. Is 100 kilos. Roman will be lifting the day after tomorrow. So 2 days out. Another set with 100. They just had me take their team picture. This looks like a pretty relaxed workout. This group gets along real well too. They all seem to be friendly. Hundred kilos again. And 100 again. Loosening up everything. Yeah, pretty thorough session of doing it. Hip circles and the arm circles and squats. Looks like he's really just trying to get very loose and relaxed. It's 100 kilos, 100. Again. Kaki Kashish Kakishvili. Kaki would have been one of the favorites, undoubtedly, in the 91 kilo class, but we just found out when we got here that he had immigrated to Greece 2 months ago, and evidently the Greek rule is that within 3 months you can represent the country. To start explaining it, in Greece evidently the rule is after 3 months a lifter can represent Greece in competition, but I think there's an IWF rule that says that if the country that the lifter was leaving disputes it, the lifter has to sit out a year. And that's what's happened with Kaki Kakishvili. Georgia is making him sit out here. He's from Georgia, as in the former Soviet Republic of Georgia. Not the state Paul Anderson legend. Georgia, in any event, is requiring that he sits out this year. Liz, he would have been one of the favorites for the 1 kilo class. Just warming up. His coach, Ivanov, who you can see in the background, is explaining to me that Kaki's got an injured leg, and they're going to wait to see how it feels before deciding how heavy he's going today. This is the same 70 kilos again. Kaki seems to be slipping on the platform and skating around. He's wearing Russian shoes that have leather soles, and they're pretty slippery. This is 110. Remember I mentioned before that you could tell Kaki was bothered by the fact that the platform seemed slippery. He's just turned sideways to actually lift on the rubber strip on the outside edge of the platform. So he's got about 2 feet of depth to work with here. But I guess anyone can do it, it's got to be him. He's the current world record holder in the snatch in the 91 kilo class. Remember, Yvon Chakarov had done 185 in Melbourne, and Kaki recently broke that with 185.5 kilos. It's 120 kilos, 120. Thank you. 140 kilos. This is Altior Zduriev, the defending 76-kilo world champion, one in Melbourne. Looks like he's got a sore left knee. He put about a half a tube of Nicoflex on that knee and rubbed it in and then bandaged it. This is 150 kilos. I just talked to Coach Ivanov how the leg was doing, and he said, fine with this weight. He says, big weight? We'll wait and see. So they still consider this a lightweight. It was 70 kilos. I think he's done a couple of sets at 50. He's very relaxed. I mean, he's competing the day after tomorrow. He's joking with everyone. On his first set with 50, he pretended he'd broken his back, put with a high pole. He's a good guy to bet on for the 76 kilo class. 160 kilos. This is 170 kilos. We're getting in a pretty serious weight here. 170 kilos. Remember, this is a 91 kilo lifter. Was intentional, if that was a miss. I don't know. Okay, we're back to Alti with 110 kilos. They say this is just going to be a very light workout for him today. Let's see what he goes up to. Okay, Taki's back with the 170. He's barely rested. It is even been a minute since he. This is the last time. He basically chalked up. Came right back over to weight. Okay. So he can do that pretty easily. Okay, here's Alto. His 30F again with 110. I'll take him with 130. I'll take 130 again. He's out for his first one from clean and jerk, 70 kilos. He's out there again with 70 again. First warm-up set for Khaki, 70 kilos. There you go, 70 kilos again. Second set. I'll do with 110. 700 kilos. He's got 180 here. Here's altitude at 115. Okay, this is 200 kilos. He's 5 kilos over the American record right now in this class. The cocky did, and remember, 235 is a 90 kilo in the Barcelona Olympics. Training's really a lot different for Roman Sebastian. Taped the same day, they're both 2 days out. Okay, Khaki's done with his workout. He's trying to take care of his knees, he indicated me. Alty's just starting to squat now for set 110. Second set, this is 140. These guys were starting to train, you know, Khaki's coach came over to me, Ivanov, and he was explaining to me that Khaki and Alty both were fine athletes and that essentially they were products of the old Soviet sports system. They started off very early and developed into the world champion, the world-class athletes that they are. Done? I think Alty's telling us this is his last set, 190, and that's going to be it. Still, it's interesting how much harder he trained than Roman Sebastian today. Altitude's got to be the odds-on favorite to win this year. Ivan Chikarov, it's one day out. I think this is the second set that's 90 kilos in the bar. This is 100 kilos. 100. Looks like Yvonne's just loosening up today. He's starting his warm-ups now with 60 kilos and a jerk. Kilos now. This is 110. Just listening up. This is 130. This is 130 again. Getting ready for a few squats, it looks like. Interesting to see how heavy he goes in squats today since he's lifting tomorrow. Just very light and snatch and clean jerk. You can see just loosening up. Well, it's just walked over this bar. It's just 70 kilos. This is 160. This is his first set. 160 kilos. Just stretching out, it looks like. This is 180 kilos, second set. Probably very light again. Well, obviously it'll be very light. This guy squats 100 kilos more than us. Look at this. Just playing around, I guess, today. Tomorrow's the big day. We'll wish him good luck. This is Andre Chemerkin. He just did a set with 70 kilos. This is 100 kilos. This is 2 days out from his competition. He'll be one of the favorites to win the Supers. 120. This is Sergei Kopitov with his back to us from Kazakhstan, and Artur Akoyev just starting to loosen up for their workout. Sergei would be lifting tomorrow, and Artur the day after tomorrow. This is 160. This is 130. Now that Andre's going for it. This guy's pretty stout. This is 160 again. This is 140. You know, if this looks light, you got to remember that Andre's capable of snatching over 200 kilos. Here's Akoyev again. Kilos. This is the lifter who, more than anyone I've ever seen, can just come out looking white hot angry right before he lifts it, just like he flips a switch. Archer Skripkin, 160 again. Oh, I'm sorry, that was 170. He slipped a couple fives in there. Now we're back to Andre Chemerkin with, this is 150, 150 kilos. With 100 kilos. Remember, he lifts the day after tomorrow. I asked him once about this anger. I said, it really looks like you get furious right before you lift. Is that really what's going on? And he looked at me as if I were crazy. I said, yes, of course. Of course I'm angry. there's Sergei Kopitov side by side now. He's warming up. Okay, he's stretched a lot, used a lot of muscle rub, taking his time. He had a very serious quad injury about a year ago, I think. Continuing his warm-up. I would think that if Sergei's in good shape, he's going to go in as one of the favorites tomorrow. Kilos tomorrow, 99-kilo class. I asked him, by the way, about his teammate, Anatoly Karpaty, who's not here, big surprise. He said Anatoly will be back next year. It's just a back injury now. I asked if Anatoly had retired, and he said no. Anatoly told me last year he planned to be around for Atlanta. We're disappointed he's not here this year. Sergey's got 50 kilos on there, and Artur's still got 100. This is 160 kilos, 160. It's 90 kilos. And Archer's up to 120 over here. Kilos, 170. Remember, this man's 2 days out. Just an intentional release of top to save some wear and tear in the shoulders. Just puts it up. Maybe not. And 120 kilos. Like we're getting ready to warm up here for some clean and jerks. This is the current world record holder, 250 kilos in the clean and jerk. Second warm-up set, 70 kilos. I don't know what the deal is on the stocking hat he just put on. But that's 140 kilos. He's smoking over there, 140. I got 120 again for Sergei Kopitov. He's just easing those back down a lot up on his shoulders.
We've got 110 here.
Warm up.
We've got 150 over here with Archer. Koyev. There's 100 kilos. Second warm-up set. This is 180 kilos, 180. We can power clean that. Pretty easy. This is 200 kilos that Skripkin's got on the bar. Looks like he's loosening up with what for him are pretty light squats. Think he goes long enough? This is 180 for our time. Look at that. Power cleans it. This is 190. And just 10 pulls. It's surprising. Oh, I didn't see that. Straps. Okay. Looks pretty easy, huh? This is 200 kilos. 200. This is 150. Yeah, interesting. Not going down below parallel, really. This is 200 kilos. Just doing parallel squats. Kind of interesting. Pretty easy squats, huh? Okay, we got 200 again. That's Chemerkin. That's 230. Pause squat. It is 230. Once again, we got the Russian coach right in the path. This is 230. Well, it looks pretty hard for him, huh? And this was 230 again, 230 kilos. Sergei Kopitov, 190. Remember, he's lifting tomorrow. He's been training pretty hard. He's doing a lot of pulls and stuff. This is 230. And remember, he lifts tomorrow. Kilos. 99 kilo lifter. Yeah, that's it for him. Wish him luck tomorrow. This is Timur Taimazov. I wish he'd turn around and see his back. Last year's world champion, 108 kilos. Look at the traps on him. I wish he'd turn around. Oh well. He's one day out. And this is Alexander Kurlovich. Just came in. He lifts in 2 days. Just came in. First time we've seen him here in the training hall. We've all been waiting for him. Probably just do light stuff today, but we'll see how he trains. It's Timur Taimazov warming up with the bar. Lifts tomorrow. Gotta be the favorite, I think, for tomorrow, too. Taimazov just loosening up his wrists. And loosening up his hips. Doing quite a bit of, not really stretching, but just loosening up all the major joints involved in lifting his ankles, knees, wrists. It's not too much for his shoulders yet, actually. Alexander's starting to loosen up a little bit. He's just been walking and visiting, chatting with Taimazov a lot. They seem to be good friends. A lot of these guys haven't seen each other for a while. I don't speak in Russian, so I don't know what they're saying, but starting to loosen up. That's 50 kilos on the bar.
Thank you.
that Sergey Kopitov has just walked in. He's competing in about 2 hours. Again for Taimazov. He's already done one or two sets with this. Sitting here, Guru was blocking my way. I didn't really want to tell him to move. Another guy from the Cuban team did.
150.
Then we compete in 2 days. Kilos. First set. Set. 70 kilos again. Won the world championship a couple days ago, literally 2 days ago, back in her training. Booster again. Looks like 140 from here. That's Taimazov. You can see in the foreground. Look at how the Germans do pulls. A lot of them do them this way. Exactly where we're always told not to do them. Kind of set yourself up. And it looks like it's going to be squat time. Probably some pretty light weights. First set 120. Taimazov with one person. This is 190. Like 240 to me. Also doesn't look very heavy, does it? Correction, that was actually 250, not 270. 250. Very easy, huh? It was 160. Tomorrow. This is one day out. He's probably just going to loosen up. He's a good possibility to be in there for a medal, particularly in the clean and jerk. Sixty kilos. High pulls that the Germans did, you know, exactly the way most people tell you not to do. Seemed to work for these guys just fine. This is 110. I don't know if it shows, but the monster using straps on this set, and now you can see them. The same 110 again, again with straps. This is 130. If Monfort does a high pull and hang power snatch again, as we did in the last set. Just seems to be loosening up, nothing heavy. This is 140, 140. This is 150 kilos. No power snatch now, just pulls. Wonder if he'll pull up to his opener. We'll see. Got 150 again. First warm-up set of clean jerk, 60 kilos. This is 140. Again. This 150. You don't often see using straps and actually cleaning it. Power cleans the straps. I don't know that he's just gonna do pulls. Former world record holder, by the way, clean jerk. 150 again. That's Frank Mantuck behind Manfred. He's the German coach. He was the bronze medal winner in 90 kilo class 1980 Olympics. Replaced Rolf Milser as the head coach for Germany. Very successful team. 150 kilos, 150. This is 160. Again. An interesting that he's power cleaning rather than going through the movement of a squat clean. But anyway, easy weight for him. Again. 110. Manfred, he's coming off a pretty recent knee operation. Since the operation, his best back squat is 290 for triple. And before that, he'd done 350 for a single. Looks like that's a wrap. And wish him a lot of luck tomorrow.